When you create a new OneNote notebook, by default, the collaboration space within that notebook is opened for all. This means that any students in your class have the ability to add to the collaboration space, edit, or delete things that are in there. If you would like to control the settings for the collaboration space, you can do that by easily accessing your Office 365 account. When you access your Office 365 account, you're going to go to the Class Notebook button, and from there, you're going to click on the Manage Notebooks button. In order to manage the notebook that you would like, just simply scroll down the list of notebooks you've created and find the one that you would like to work with. By default, your collaboration space is going to be unlocked, so if you would like to lock it, meaning that no students in the class will be able to add anything to that section, just toggle on the button by clicking it. At this point, the collaboration space is locked. No students can add anything to this. You have the ability to lock and unlock this as you feel is necessary. As you go through the year, you might decide that you would like the students to be able to work within the collaboration space, but you would like them to be able to work in groups. OneNote now has the ability for you to give certain students permissions to certain sections within the collaboration space. So for instance, if you have three groups of students in your class, you can set three different collaboration space sections, one for group one, one for group two, and one for group three, and you could assign specific students to each of those groups. Only those students that you give permission to in that group would be allowed to add any documents. So to do that, you would click on collaboration space permissions. So if I wanted to add a new section to the collaboration space and call this group one, I can then go through and I could choose the students who I want to have the ability to be able to add or alter any documents that are within that section. If I would like the other students to be able to see what is there, I could give them read-only access, but if I want this to be a private space for the group, I would keep that box unchecked. From here, I would hit Create. I can continue this process by adding a group 2 and selecting those students that I would like to be able to give access to and hitting the Create button. After I have finished creating the groups or the sections that I would like the students to be able to work in, and I've assigned the students permissions to those groups, I can go ahead and hit Close. When I click on the purple binder, it's going to launch the full version of OneNote, and after all of the information syncs down, we'll be able to go into the collaboration space and see the sections that were just created. Now when I go and click on collaboration space, you will see that the sync has completed and now I have a section for group 1, group 2, and group 3. So only the students that I've assigned permissions to each of those sections are now able to add or revise any information in there. These are all changeable as you feel is necessary throughout the year, and the easiest way to get there is to just simply go back to your Office homepage, click on Class Notebook, and go ahead and manage your notebook and select which one you would like to work with.